So we will be hitting the cafe, and of course Amano wants to place it a bit further here, but that means all of the artillery won't really be able to hit it, and will instead hit the building instead, thus prolonging the life of your bunker. Remember this for all of sort of structures on the field, placing them behind a building if you're suspecting your opponent will throw artillery on you can really do a lot to protect it, and of course if you're under a heavy artillery strike, getting them behind a building can again also help. Of course this again only applies to on map. Again, off map might certainly also help a bit since buildings will absorb some of the damage, but it's most effective with on map, who actually have to fly in a parabolic arc. Anyhow, back to the match. Sniper caught behind enemy lines, cut off from his brethren, and forced retreat. Not looking good at all, and a marksman shot knocking him out, getting revenge for the Tommy C taken out. He shall be mourned, and now things are really looking bad. German troops are a bit dispersed, will have to move up to support. I've forgotten the Grenadiers, it seems the half track is there. Gunners blazing away, covering everything. Pioneers moving back slowly. And what do we see? The support truck moving out, and we have an armor truck on the way as well. And Pioneer team is lost, trying to cover, and Sappers with Piats are moving in as well. Armor command truck is on the way. Half track is out of control, absolutely horrific. Really having managed to tear apart my defensive line because of my mistakes. Grenadiers taking up cover in this building, firing away, killing one. Killing one sapper in the process. Rest of British troops are firing 8 rifle grenades, going in, doing quite a bit of damage, but not killing anyone, much to my luck. Mortar team setting up this pioneer team, quickly scavenging what they can from the half track before getting out of there. And we see pioneers moving in, perhaps with a flamethrower. The sappers are going to take shots at this bunker, but the pioneers are possibly going to get into the bunker themselves. And now we see a commando insertion right there, completely encapsulating my troops right here. Flamethrowers have been equipped for the pioneers though, which means they can do a bit of nasty damage to those inside the cafe. First grenadiers moving in from the north, MP40s blazing away, taking a bit of damage, but they are putting quite a lot of pressure on those British troops. Pioneers hiding inside the bunker, fire flaming away at everyone outside. And we see the commandos being quite dangerous, and these grenadiers are still holding out, knocking out the glider with their panzer trick, denying anyone's being able to reinforce. The pack has also been cleared up, quite lethal. My defenses have certainly been shattering, and it is now a desperate last stand to hold out also here in the south. But looks like this infantry section will be knocked out by these remaining Volksgrenadiers. But returning up here, commandos cutting on off this point, leaving me without control on this direct supply. But the medics bravely managed to pull back enough wounded troops for this grenadier team to get out of there with a bit more experience, composed of a bit of this and that. Now taking up cover. Commanders moving in, grenade going off, killing a lot of British troops, and a rifle grenade section is lost. Commandos not loving grenades though, might have been useful to clear out that bunker, but for some reason he forgot grenadiers still in there. And now we have stormtroopers of the 2nd SS ready to try and stabilize the situation. Assault rifles blazing away, and now forcing the last of the British defenders away, but at what cost? A lot of lost men for me. Pack knocked out, but I barely managed to hold on, but really I think with the infantry section lost and whatnot, I'm not entirely sure it will have been to the advantage of the British, but it certainly managed to push me off my feet. Not entirely sure what he means with lame VP, but perhaps he might explain. Grenadiers still in there hiding, perhaps needing a bit of a schnapps to regain their calm. Foot Grenadiers deeply wounded, retaking this point while fresh troops are moving in with a mortar team in the background. And we see a Sturm armory going up, and sappers are on their feet again, forcing the stormtroopers behind, taking up a bit of cover behind some of the walls and firing away again. Assault rifles blazing, and now grenadier team moving in to support. Sapper Piat rounds landing amongst them, but not much luck. Grenade going off. Sappers miraculously getting away while killing a single grenadier, certainly looking up to be a lot of tough fighting. And we have the radio thingy, I can't remember the name of it, but he's certainly able to sneak in on my communications, knowing I have a Sturm armory. Certainly not bad being able to tap in on your enemy's communications. The bunker is still standing, albeit it's of course not looking too good. but it is still there, and that is what is count. Stormtroopers taking up defensive positions, ready to ambush in proper stormtrooper style. Commando sneaking in, unawares of the stormtroopers. Who will get the drop on who? Someone hitting a mine, apparently there, I suspect, laying down a mine to protect this point. Stormtroopers caught out in the open and cut down by the commandos. Absolutely horrific. Absolutely sloppy, in fact, but there you go. Medics quickly rushing in to pick up the wounded stormtroopers, bravely carrying them back. Commandos picking up a pack, and now mortar rounds landing. Commandos charging in, sabers as well, grenadiers out on the field. Apparently being having managed to get out. Stack out for British and a Stuke out for me. MP40 equipped full grenadiers cutting down these storm commandos who for some reason rushed in after the mortar, but apparently without support. Pack firing away, going to knock out this bunker, I fear, if not. Down quickly, and there we go. The medic bunker is lost. Being slowly edged out of this town, and now the Staghound is on the field, machine guns and gun blazing, managing a few kills. Really the toughest armored car to ever exist. In fact, it has the health of a tank, which can cause some problem, and it does not really commend any health points, but at the same time it's a rather tough reconnaissance vehicle, so it's certainly not entirely bad. And of course the machine gun is deadly. It will be nerfed a bit, but it will still be quite lethal. Now we see the Stuke moving out, ready to show this armored car who is the boss, if at least it could manage to stay in the range of fire. Stuke missing, the Stuke commander cursing, and what is this? A kangaroo! Oh, that sneaky fellow getting the dreaded kangaroo, and we are not talking the Australian kind, we are talking the armored troop-filled kind. Moving in through here behind the hedgerows, apparently not entirely sure what but might be using the chaos caused by the Staghound to move in. And if used probably will certainly be able to cause a lot of damage. Plenty of manpower. What will he use it for? I'm not sure. But he might certainly actually use it. Get some perhaps some more commandos. Get some more armor on the field. And might actually try and get these victory points. But he seems to have forgotten all about them. Apparently a bit too concerned here about taking these points. Might cost him dearly, in fact. And let's return to jolly old me. Also getting access to the Stu, but not really feeling the need for the Stu 42 at the moment. And we see the pack moving up. Commandos locking it ahead. Kangaroo Blast still occupying most of my forces, but now finding themselves surrounded as Panzerschreck equipped troops and the Stu moving in. Might aim it, and we do have a second Stuke out, in fact. Kangaroo moving ahead, and the lieutenant is on his own. Grenadiers occupying this building quickly to take shots at this lieutenant, who has for some reason left himself on the own. The kangaroo is completely inside the base. Still not sure why he hasn't gone for these victory points though. If he perhaps had not rushed so far into my base and perhaps focused on these victory points, he might actually have won, but currently he's not going to be winning. Reconstruction is moving up here though, but I think it is too little too late. Pioneers blasting away with his MP40s, taking shots at the reconstruction. Kangaroo deadly exposed, caught in the ditch, and there we go, the kangaroo is wrecked. Pack, no, not the pack, it's the Staghound, but there we go, the pack opening fire, and a loss of victory points. So there you go, a victory for the 2nd Panzer Division, halting the move of the 11th Armored and securing the battlefield for one more night. So, what can we learn from this? Well, for starters, you might want to learn that, of course, not constantly attacking in the same point, in particular when your opponent has defended it, is not going to do well. In fact, it was only when he managed a rather daring maneuver here and forced me to shift my defenses that he was able to launch further attacks in the south and later on in the center again by forcing me to move out and to attack him in a position which of course suited him quite well. Stuff like that can really make a difference, and of course it did, but it was really too little too late perhaps. Then of course came the commanders, rather sneaky, but he wasn't really able to get enough up to continue the attack. And then when he finally managed to push me out of the city, he overextended. If he had instead held back, perhaps just fortified this, going for this as well, He might actually force me into another situation where I have to attack at great losses, and of course leave the situation much more in his favor, and who knows how long this match could then have gone on for. Instead, though, he chose to attack me and my base. It certainly looked a bit alright, but I was able to, of course, attack him in great numbers and knock out his assets. And of course, he completely forgot about the victory points. So, there you go. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, why not subscribe or tell your friends, and if you didn't, why not send in a replay of your own? This is Imperial Dane saying remember to get those victory points. Cheers.